And the celebrations continued back home, thousands gathering in parks in the state's central west to remember the big part Australia played in putting man on the moon.
From the moon to a dish in an Australian sheep paddock. 50 years on, the historic moment for parks is revisited.
I'm stuck on that mark. Picture right. You might pass on to the park people that their labour was not in vain. They've given us the best TV yet.
The New South Wales town swamped by thousands to remember the day man landed on the moon.
I've got an EMU, an extravehicular mobility unit.
So I came from Boston.
Workers who helped beam the pictures of the first moonwalk to 600 million people back where they say they belong.
It was a special thing for us and for our whole team.
That's pretty amazing that it's all succeeded and we had a part in putting those three people up there.
Today they were joined by astronauts of the future and the past.
Did you think at the time watching it that you yourself would be up in space one day?
No.
The US still grateful to Australians who helped show history unfold.
Today is a great day to be the United States ambassador.
The dish also had a starring role on the big screen.
Are we stuffed?
Yep, we're stuffed.
But at 12:56 p.m. on July 21, 1969, Neil Armstrong's famous steps were actually transmitted from the dish at Honeysuckle Creek outside Canberra. The park's dish was hit by freak winds and the moon was out of reach.
Yeah, it wasn't real good.
Eventually, NASA took the park's signal and the rest is history.
NASA's planning to send mankind back to the moon in the next 5 years, and Australia could play a role, meaning the park's radio telescope could have another chapter in the history books.
And another generation can reach for the stars.
I want to go to Mars.
Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.